Hey everyone, Ronnie Chavez here, and today we're gonna learn how to jump from height or roofs or just high things in general without getting hurt. Now, before actually ever trying to jump off of anything higher than waist high or anything like that, you want to have a solid safety roll down. So be sure to check out my tutorial on the safety roll so that you can have that mastered and you're ready to start taking it to higher heights. Now, even if you have the safety roll mastered, before you even think about doing super high jumps off of high objects, it's not about even having a perfect safety roll on flat ground. It's about lots of practice and training and progression to go into higher drops. And it's gonna take more leg strength and very specific, precise timing on the roll. And if none of those things are in place, then you will and can be injured doing high drops. So make sure that you have all those things in place as you prepare to learn how to do high drops. Now, the other thing to keep in mind when learning how to jump from height is that you don't want to train this often. You can train from lower height, dropping into and doing the safety roll often, but you don't want to jump from really high heights all the time, because even with proper technique and even if it's not feeling like you're injuring yourself, it can still cause damage and impact to your joints over time. So you want to minimize the amount you actually practice this, just enough so that you know how to do it in case the situation ever arose where you need to be able to jump from something high and land safely. Something else to keep in mind when you're on a high drop is to be sure to spot where you want to go and aim to land there. So because there's another drop over there, I don't want to jump too far out this way so I don't accidentally roll off the edge over there. So I'm actually jumping at an angle so that I can have more room to do the roll and have more space. So just constantly be aware of your surroundings and make sure that you check the area you're landing, the ground, close up for any divots or hidden holes or rocks in the ground. Because if you land on a rock or hole from a high drop, your ankle is gonna be busted hardcore, and then you won't even be doing the roll out of it properly, so you'll also be slamming your body into the ground. So make sure that before learning this move that you're as safe as possible, you scout out your environment, you start low, get very comfortable, and at any point, if at any height, you feel like it was a lot of impact and hard on your body, then you're jumping too high and you need to go much lower and train there until you're much more confident and capable of going higher. And sometimes it's just a matter of practicing a lot from lower heights before even thinking about going high. Now, when you begin your journey to start practicing drops from height with the safety roll, the number one thing you want to do is start from low height. So after you have your safety roll mastered on flat ground, then you want to start with just a low ledge. It can be as high as a curb, just whatever you're comfortable with, just so you can get the timing of what it's like to land and then roll. And so I actually found this perfect area. If you can find an area like this similarly, that's awesome, but you don't have to. You can find different height ledges anywhere you can find them. But here you can see we have this wall that gets higher and higher. So this is great because I can slowly progress into a height drop that I'm comfortable with. So I can start on this low ledge here and slowly work my way up until I'm at a point where I can feel my progression doing it. So that's what you want to do when practicing the height drops, is practice progression. Start small, get really comfortable on low ledges, and slowly, slowly work your way up. So now that you have those things in mind, what you want to actually be practicing for the technique from jumping from height is you want to be thinking about how you're going to be dispersing the impact across the ground and not just taking it in one solid point. So if you're just dropping and just taking it all in one jump, then you're going to be feeling a lot of that in your legs and knees. It's going to wear you out really fast and do more damage to your joints if you're not properly conditioned. If you have worked on your leg strength a lot, doing squats and plyometrics and lots of other things, then you will be able to take higher drops without feeling as much impact, but you still don't want to do that frequently because of the long-term joint damage it can cause. But if you are doing it, you know, spaced out over time, then for the most part you'll be okay, as long as you're only training at a level you're currently capable of. whatever level jump you're doing, you want to focus on making sure you're jumping forward, because that's going to allow your momentum to more easily be dispersed across the ground through the roll. Because if you're just doing a straight drop with no momentum, a lot of that impact is still going to go into your legs, and then you'll do a roll. Whereas if you have a little bit of forward momentum, that's going to throw you into the roll easier and not as much direct impact absorbing in your legs. I personally like to lean forward just a little bit and stretch out with my arms and body as I jump forward, and then I'm going to tuck my knees in just so that I can be in a position in the air that I feel comfortable and have control of. And I'm gonna pretty much hold that tuck until the last second that I can open up my legs, extend them completely, slightly bent, and then absorb the impact with my legs to push myself into the roll. Now, the reason I'd like to tuck, and you'll see a lot of people tuck in the air, because it gives you more control while you're in the air and more timing on your landing. Otherwise, if you're just doing a straight drop with your body straight, it's just, one, it's not gonna look aesthetically as cool, and two, you're going to lack a little bit in the way of timing and technique when actually landing. So being able to tuck allows you to control kind of the angle and positioning of your body, so depending on how you're falling, you can stretch your legs out accordingly to land the way you want to. Now, upon impact, you wanna make sure that you're landing with your toes extended, because that's just gonna be a little bit of extra absorption, and you don't wanna be landing on your heels, especially from really high, because that'll definitely cause damage. And if you're not doing it on something soft like grass, like on concrete, then you have a real risk of bruising your heels. So make sure you land with your toes out and that you're landing leaning forward. So you're almost, as you're landing, you're pushing yourself forward and falling forward, but immediately tucking into that safety roll so that all that impact can be pushed forward and spread out through that roll. And if done correctly, you'll feel quite a bit of force through the roll. You'll feel it pretty heavily on your back, not like a flat back, but just the rolling along it, you'll feel heavy. But the faster you roll and the more spaced out that roll is, the less impact that's going to be. And that's the whole idea, is that you're dispersing that impact through your body, through the roll. So you're not feeling it at any one point on your body, but you're feeling that impact throughout so that it doesn't cause as much impact. The way I like to think about it is like you're throwing a ball off of a high drop. If you just simply drop the ball, it's going to come down, bounce, and bounce up pretty high, which means there's a lot of impact going into that ball and coming back up. Whereas if you throw the ball out, then it's going to hit the ground and it's still gonna bounce, but more of that energy is going to be bounced forward and disperse more of that impact, because the ball can also roll. And that's how you wanna think of your body, is that you're being thrown out and rolling out so that impact is being pushed forward instead of all of it coming straight down. Now, I wouldn't say there's any set height for how high you can go doing high drops, because I've seen people go really high. I wouldn't recommend that you aim to go really high, but just learn how to do a comfortable height that, you know, is you might find in normal situations. So those are all things you want to keep in mind for jumping off height, jumping off roofs, whatever it is you want to eventually be able to do. Let me know if you have any questions about this move or requests for future tutorials. This move is, I know, a super common one to see in the parkour world, and although it's discouraged to train regularly, I know it's something that is really cool and fun to do. You just have to be very cautious and careful with doing it, and that you train in the correct way so that you don't get injured. So just keep that in mind. But otherwise, as always, thank you everyone for watching this video. Be sure to subscribe for more tutorials, and thanks for watching.